Thank you, Debbie, for bringing out some of the best reggae hits that people have to hear these days. Anyway, you are back with me, Ceegee, Northern Radio 103.5 FM, and this is your favorite pedal to the metal or just stuck in traffic jams. Yeah, like I did that there. Back to the basics today with Kinda Blue, Miles Davis. We got a few special guests today, or at least one, so I'm going to line them up right now. First, what's your name?
Scratch Bastid.
What you doing for the world?
Spreading good vibes via good music and good barbecue.
So, what would you consider to be your top inspiration?
Oh, probably, well, in the realm of soul music, I would say Stevie Wonder. In the realm of jazz music, I would say it would be John Coltrane. And in the realm of rap, I would probably say Nas.
Yeah, I'm sure that's lovely. For me, it's always been Waltz for Debbie. Bill Evans is cool, tribute to one of the most beautiful ladies who ever circulated around the jazz scene back in the early 1960s. I'd say, I think about 1962. Of course, Pershing and Jazz also was a real uplifter. Any other time. Undercurrent 2, 1962, right before he got together with Oscar Peterson. Well, maybe just a little bit after. Yep, because I think it was in The Colony in 1958 where he hooked up with Miles. Coltrane was on that bandwagon too. Back before Coltrane was really making his own sort of foot in the sand, if you so to speak. What's the latest record you bought?
The last record that I bought was a Bajan Fleetwood Mac label yacht rock band called... I forget what it's called, but it's on Tusk Records.
That sounds like an interesting genre of music. What's your favorite jazz era?
I'd probably say the 60s was my favorite jazz era. By that time, they had it swinging, but a little leaning towards commercial, which, for me, I guess that's where I'm at now. But jazz is a continuous adventure as I go on in life. That's what I find.
Who's your favorite superhero and why?
I wasn't expecting that question, but Mr. Freeze?
Well, Black Panther's had a big influence on the whole jazz scene, I gotta tell you that. Yeah. No, really, there was a whole lot of exchange between the Panthers and you know, some of the greatest musicians you know. I mean, of course, Pharoah Sanders and Coltrane, they had their own interactions because the whole Black Arts movement was started there by Amiri Baraka downtown before he moved uptown after the assassination of Mr. Malcolm X. That really changed the whole vibe. And of course, the Panthers, which were an Oakland-based organization, well, there are a whole lot of jazz cats out in Oakland and San Francisco, you know, the whole Bay Area, who were really ready to get engaged and take that mission to the stage and articulate those very important words into music. Yeah.
Sure.
Tell me, what do you miss about the old days?
Well, I'm not that old, so... I guess maybe just, you know, lack of responsibility and living fancy free. And not that I don't do that now, but, you know, less dependence, I guess.
I have no idea who Nas is. Hey, we're out of time, but we got to wrap this up. So real quick, comedy or horror?
Comedy.
Books or movies?
Neither. Music.
James Bond, Jason Bourne, or John Wick?
James Bond.
Classic or modern?
A fusion of the two.
Breakfast or dinner?
Dinner.
Singing or rapping?
Rapping.
European or American?
European.
A gunfight or a knife fight?
Ooh, let's keep the peace.
Get $4,000 per week or $3 million right now?
$3 million right now.
Piano or guitar?
Piano.
Would you rather be the funniest person in the room or the most intelligent?
Most intelligent.
Wasabi or Tabasco?
Bastard's hot sauce.
Anything new you're working on you want to plug?
It's the start of barbecue season, so I guess you could say I'm working on my belt line.
Thank you so much for coming on. We're out of time right here at 103.5 FM Northern Radio Traffic Jams. But coming up is Catherine with the news.
Have fun.